Creep on in, on in, on in. Welcome to what I'm hoping will just be a quick little video. Just got to get this off my chest. I saw Us last weekend. Really enjoyed it. I'm going to see it one more time before I actually commit anything to paper, so to speak, or to the Tripping Through Gateways blog about it. Which, I apologize, I've not kept up very well in March. And so, going forward, hoping to fix that problem a bit there. But I liked the movie. Thought it was great. Okay, so earlier this week, Jordan Peele spoke at the East Hollywood, at the Improv Mecca Upright Citizens Brigade Theater. And he discussed the power that he has now as far as with casting. And being able to cast black people as leads for his films. His exact words were, "The way I look at it, I get to cast black people in my movies. I feel fortunate to be in this position where I can say to Universal, I want to make a $20 million horror movie with a black family, and they say yes. I don't see myself casting a white dude as the lead in my movie. Not that I don't like white dudes, but I've seen that movie. It's really one of the best, greatest pieces of this story is feeling like we are in this time, a renaissance has happened and proved the myths about representation in the industry are false." Now, the explosive response, primarily from white people, but not exclusively, was, "This is discrimination, this is racism, specifically racial discrimination. How do you think white people feel being told they're not going to be cast in a Jordan Peele movie? It's not right for him to say that. That's racist." And especially people have loved to go back to the notion of, well, what if Steven Spielberg said that? What if Steven Spielberg said, "I'm only going to cast white people in my movies. I just can't see myself casting black people." But the funny thing is, with like the Spielberg example, outside of one film, none of his movies feature a person of color. None of his other movies, The Color Purple is the only movie that was actually about a black experience. His leads are overwhelmingly white. And that's kind of been Hollywood for practically since its inception. The fact is, maybe it's not fair, but considering Mickey Rooney and John Wayne both played Asian people, as did Christopher Lee, movies get whitewashed to have from real stories to suddenly have white leads all the time. And when that stuff gets brought up, it gets kind of shooed away as being not a big deal. Jordan Peele is interested in telling different stories. Stories that don't have a place for a white lead. Now, this isn't even a guarantee. He says he can't see himself. That could change. He could find himself down the road going, you know what? I have a great idea for a white lead character. But I don't see why he should have to. This is... He should get to tell the stories he's looking to tell. We haven't demanded or forced other directors to tell stories they don't want to tell. I mean, Woody Allen gets to tell stories about neurotic Jewish guys all the time who date younger women. I mean, that's all... That's... I mean, the fact is there's nothing controversial in what he's saying. And the fact that people are trying to make it controversial or make it even a hugely negative thing is just, it's ridiculous. And when I listen to white people try and articulate ideas on why it's bad in this turnaround, so to speak. So I was watching this Collider video on this. And apparently the day before they'd actually had a really controversial one where they mainly had a bunch of white people talking about it. And one of the white guys called it reverse racism. It's not reverse racism, folks. And it was very delicately worded. So people trying to argue that, well, maybe it was badly worded. No, it was worded perfectly fine. There was no reason. There's nothing controversial about what he's saying. It's nothing controversial. And he's... this notion that what he said was really, you know, like, oh my gosh, you know, it was just indelicately worded at least. No. Because here's what happens with white people in discussions of racial inequalities. Invariably, a black guy will say something like, I had to go to the dentist and get my tooth drilled today because I had a cavity, so I got a filling. And the white person's response is, oh, so what you're saying is, you think I've never had to get a filling for a cavity at the dentist? It jumps to a defensive, accusatory tone. And there was nothing in here. He wasn't pointing a finger at white people saying white people suck. He wasn't saying white people shouldn't get work. He was saying, for the stories I want to tell, I'm not that interested in telling yet another story about a white guy. There's plenty of people out there telling stories about white guys. And in this Collider video, when they were talking back and forth, this white guy kept doing that defensive thing where people would express situations they faced as a kid, you know, or, you know, my parents were always telling me this and this, and he would counter with, oh, you think my parents didn't tell me to do that? My parents didn't tell me to work hard? No, they never didn't say shit. I'm sorry. They didn't say anything about your life, man. They were talking about theirs, about their experiences and about the struggles they had. White people really need to shut up about this stuff sometimes. When people are telling you things about their experiences, instead of trying to reverse it and gain the power in the conversation, shut up and listen. And really, I don't mean keep your mouth shut while you formulate your retort. I mean, listen, take it in. And I'm just going to keep coming back to the fact that this is... what Peele said is not controversial, nor is it racist, and nor is he advocating some sort of grand textbook case of racial discrimination. The fact is if your movie is about a black guy or a black woman, then a white man shouldn't be up for the role, period. I don't care how good of an actor you think you are. Don't worry, guys. There's plenty of roles out there for white people, and especially in the realm of white leads. It took 18 movies in the Marvel Universe to have a black lead. It took 20 to have a female lead. Your jobs aren't going anywhere. And if you want to work with Jordan Peele, you still have that chance. You're just probably not going to be the lead guy in the movie. And that shouldn't be a bother to you. You know what? Maybe it is a little quote-unquote unfair. But Hollywood has been unfair to a lot of people for a long time. And maybe, just maybe, balancing things out will mean that for a time, it's unfair for the white guy. But you know what? If unfair means you're not up for a couple directors, but you can look forward to working for lots of other directors as the lead, first world problems, man. His statements were perfectly fine as they were, and if you're upset by them, you just really need to chill out. You just need to lighten up a bit. Stop being so easily triggered. Let go. Because all the arguments I've heard to try and claim he is racist come down to, quote, taking the words out of the greater context. Because if you are going to ignore the whole part about how it's exciting to him to be able to actually hire black casts to be the leads of his movies, black actors and actresses to be leads, and you're only going to focus on the, I don't see myself, well, then you are taking it out of context. You are ignoring it, and you aren't being honest in your criticism. And again, hey, listen, white guys, you got plenty of options. There's plenty of directors out there who are making movies about white leads. So thanks for listening. So if you liked it, you can hit the like button. If you don't like it, you're free to hit the not like. You can comment below. You can also interact on the Tripping Through Gateways website. You can reach me at Twitter at Tom Wade, which is spelled TOMWADE. Otherwise, thanks for listening and have a great day. A flower was born.